Creating the illusion of a bump in the road could be a safer new pathway for pedestrians.
I don't want her death to be in vain. I want changes.
Since her 15-year-old daughter was hit by two vehicles and killed on her way to school, Shauna Rodriguez has worked tirelessly attending city council meetings to make the streets safer for other kids.
Whatever I've got to do, it's painful, it's hard. I wish I could have brought Gabby home, but I can't. So if I can save just one person, that's going to honor my kid.
Councilman Jeff Pastor called for council to look into the cost and possibility of putting 3D crosswalks at all school zones within the city. The method uses paint to create an optical illusion of a speed hump. From a car, it looks as if the crosswalk is floating off the ground.
We would like for the first 3D crosswalk to be at the site where Gabriella Rodriguez unfortunately lost her life. But it's a larger discussion about the elderly, about the handicapped, about students, and the need for us to protect them.
A need for pedestrian protection put at the forefront of council meetings in the past year due to far too many incidents of people getting hit in and out of crosswalks.
In 1 week, I think we had 3 or 4, and, you know, by the grace of God, they got to go home.
Now today, council voted unanimously to continue exploring the cost and the timeline for these 3D crosswalks. Jeff Pastor said that there are some organizations that have offered to fund the crosswalks completely free. He hopes to have them installed in these high traffic areas that also serve as school zones, like right here along Central Parkway. Reporting live, Ashley Kirkland, WLWT News 5.